Now, let's head across to another conversation, post-budget. Now, let me welcome Dipen Sheth, the Head Institutional Research of HDFC Securities, to the show. Dipen, good morning and welcome. Let's talk about what is your assessment of the budget and what could be the implications sectorally or stock-wise from the budget. What can we deduce from the budget?
So the headline take certainly is that it's mildly populist, and maybe a little more than mildly. So you can see that huge farm income transfer scheme, and also a little bit of that marginal relief for small taxpayers with incomes below 500,000 rupees. So, and of course the sensible bits of populism in past budgets, particularly the last budget, seem to continue, whether it's food subsidy, the Ujwala gas connections, the Swabhagya Power Scheme, the Swachh Bharat Sanitation Scheme, Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, a little bit of incremental spend on all of these schemes, Ayushman Bharat, we are a little puzzled with the arithmetic there. And now, of course, the PM Kisan or the Farm Income Transfer Scheme. This was largely expected because this is an election year and there is admittedly real stress in the rural heartland. So it's not that good politics is completely bad economics right now. There was a requirement for this. But it does look like that fiscal prudence looks postponed for the next government to manage, whether it's this one or some other coalition or party. There isn't much of recklessness, but certainly the assumptions on tax collections look a tad optimistic, and I would be surprised if the government is able to contain borrowings, market borrowings, within the limits that it has prescribed for the coming year. Having said all of this, let me lace this with the usual disclaimer that, you know, I think we've reached a stage in the economic affairs of this country where we should look at union budgets as statements of government accounts rather than instruments of policy.
Right, so that's another a strong statement coming from Dipen. But Dipen, one word. Let's talk about sectorally again, because I was going through your sort of a report, which again came for the budget here. From a sector or a stock perspective, is it something which is now actually going to get more sort of attention from the institution investors, which you feel, realty, housing finance, consumption, anything which you think could be looking like a good sort of tactical beneficiary from the budget?
So I certainly feel that some of the large banks which are exposed to corporate stress, if I can say so, are in for some cyclical healing. There is strong evidence of this, in fact a very strong bit of evidence of this in the results of both Axis Bank and SBI. SBI we are a little more skeptical as to whether this headline improvement in asset quality does reflect the entire reality, because we were a little upset in the sense that they didn't provide adequately on a couple of stressed exposures. But having said that, I must confess that a broader turnaround in corporate asset quality augurs very well for Axis, for ICICI Bank, and of course for the State Bank of India. Axis is of course our top pick here. It's being led by a dynamic, swashbuckling new leader, if I may say so, who is now succeeding in attracting top shot talent from across the industry into Axis Bank. Our own bank has lost a couple of people there, and obviously you would have read news about some other people joining in from places like Federal Bank or even Yes Bank. And I think all of this talent is now going to make a huge difference to the healing trajectory, the growth trajectory, and the sharpening of metrics at Axis. I think it's only a matter of time that Axis should get re-rated to an even higher multiple. Particularly if I look at it in the light of what's happened or what's being told about in the budget, if the government decides to step on the divestment pedal, there's a huge stock of supply for the Axis stock in the Suti holdings. Paradoxically, right. Axis will benefit if that supply comes into the market, because I think foreign investors will lap it up.
Sure.
And that might itself lead to some change of multiples.
Point taken. So we'll take that again. Axis could be a beneficiary here. Again, the market again has been seeing that, but depend. As always, thanks a lot for coming on the show and giving us some insights how again this budget could be giving some new themes, some new inferences. Again, it was an interim budget, but again definitely the market is finding its own themes from the sort of smaller degree of announcements, but definitely reality consumption again will be coming on that. But that's all we had on this edition of Opening Trade. It's time now to take a break, but stay tuned, as up next is Trending Today.